So I wanna be conscious of my orbit. Sometimes you're gonna see this and you're gonna see the disc is orbit. What's up guys, it's Eric Johnson from Arete Throws Nation, and in today's video we are going to take a clip from our recent virtual camp. If you are watching this video, it's happening live. If you're watching this video 6 months after it happened, I think it's going to be available on our website. You can dive in at any time, so check it out. And what we're going to do now is we're going to go through our first throwing segment. What we're going to do is have you warm up with this, whether you're a more advanced thrower or you're a beginner. We're going to feel some things and it's going to restrict some motions, and you want to pay attention to how that's feeling. So what we're gonna do is the kneeling throws. The first thing that we talked about, we did the drills and we talked about setting up our sequence. I'm gonna put here and I'm gonna do this and you're gonna see me. So I'm gonna have this camera, and I'm gonna be throwing this way. So what I'm gonna do is, remember, when I put the knees here, we're looking at the arm swing. So you're gonna see how I create that big wind, and you're gonna see this, right? And what I'm, one of the things I'm working on is getting that discus a little bit higher. So I wanna be conscious of my orbit. Sometimes you're gonna see this and you're gonna see the discus orbit drop. And we wanna make sure that the radius stays nice and high. We're gonna be winding flat, and you're gonna notice when I wind flat. And what I wanna do is really create length so that I feel myself almost falling into the throw. When I throw, when I create this length, it's gonna create a natural motion of blocking, and you're gonna notice how that pulls me forward. This is gonna be really important. So what you're really trying to do is you're gonna realize that from the knees down is where the difficulty comes in locking your hips. So this is why we teach, when we teach that 1, 2, 3, 4 sequence, we're making sure that we feel our weight on the inside of the wind side foot. With the kneeling throw, again, we're gonna go here. We're gonna go 1, 2, 3, and you're gonna see me through. Hope. Okay, so you're gonna see how I kind of lunge forward. So this is why, again, we would have a towel, or if I'm on the grass. So basically you're gonna see me, you know, set it up, stay nice and long, and you're gonna feel me hit the throw and come forward, and that means I'm engaging. Now here's the common things you're gonna watch. A lot of times people are gonna wind, they're gonna wind low, discus is gonna drop low, and they're gonna pull around. So if you're not falling forward, you don't have this position, because as soon as I put this position, I reach a little bit more, it's here. When I'm in a full throw or my stand throw, we're gonna be wanting to do the same thing. Super long, so that we feel how the lower body can move. That long path of the upper body is what's gonna allow your lower body to move ahead of the discus. So again, the whole point of the kneeling throw is to be able to feel that separation and stretch reflex, and you wanna be conscious of the orbit and the radius at the same time. Avoid sitting back, you're gonna avoid pushing your shoulders back. These are the cheats, is to push your butt back. But you'll notice when I push my butt back, why is this a cheat? Because it helps you stay out here, which is a better balance position, but it's not the right position. We wanna keep our hips up underneath, so we're feeling this stretch, so we're gonna feel our block engage, and we're gonna be here so we come forward into the throw. Most of the time I'll have a lot of my athletes just doing it on the grass. I want you to do it on the grass. It's super simple. Again, you may want a towel, but oftentimes you don't need it. Just find a grassy patch, and that way when you come forward and fall forward, super simple, super easy. Give that a try. Now, here's the thing we're gonna be looking for. Again, we talked about, don't sit back, don't pull around, and if you're pulling around, chances are this motion is here, and you're gonna notice how it just forces you to turn the shoulder in front. If you're a more advanced guy, this is still gonna be a benefit because it's gonna make you feel. If you're a younger thrower, it's really vital, because what you're gonna do is you're just gonna be able to feel that. And if you don't feel that, this is where you want this to kind of come into play. It makes a big difference. Again, you're gonna focus on keeping your hips under you, because when we throw, that's what we want. We want the hips under us so we can always turn the hips more at the finish. And we're gonna dive into that, and we're gonna break down your pre-blocks and your stand throws in the videos coming up.